Hi, my name is Tom and you are at level 33 in Mastering Einstein's Special Relativity. The previous 32 levels we learned all the theory around the Special Relativity, and in this level we are going to apply our knowledge to the second best known example in Special Relativity, and that is fitting a big rocket in a small shed and actually take a picture of it to prove that it actually happened. In the A level we saw animations, I will run them again, and then we will dive in a little bit more by examining the space-time diagram. Let's get into it. The big rocket in the small shed. Some recap. We know fast objects shrink. Classic length contraction. See level 28. We know that if you are in the object moving, you don't experience this contraction. It's from the stationary point of view. In level 32, we learned a lot about objects moving towards us and moving away from us when we actually put it on video. This is what we learned. When they come at us, they appear to be larger, faster, and further away. And when they move away from us, they appear to be smaller, slower, and closer than the real thing. So let's do the experiment. We will have a rocket of 25 meters and a fixed shed of 20 meters, and the rocket will be running, flying at 80% of the speed of light, and then we will see what happens. These are the four animations I showed in the previous level. Top row, what actually happens in the world of the farmer is on the left top corner, but what he videotapes is on the top right corner, which will be completely different than what actually happens. The bottom row will be the rocket's perspective, what really happened on the left and what was on the video on the right. Clocks are synced, and I mean the farmer's clocks in both animations are the same. The same for the rocket clocks, but they are not synced between farmer and rocket due to time dilation. Just watch and enjoy what happens. How different, four different realities, of which two are actually true, but seem to be way incompatible with each other. There we go. You see the stretching, the moving way faster, and you will see the shrinking and moving way slower once the rocket passes the camera point, or the shed passes the camera point. We're losing simultaneity. Head doors are not closing and opening at the same time in the world of the rocket, but they are in the world of the farmer. I mean, this is a total nightmare if you would compare notes, if the astronaut and the farmer would come together and show their videotapes, I don't know what would happen, you know. How can you beat the videotape? Well, and this is in the days where they didn't have any deep fakes, right? This is true, unedited videotape, and it's totally incompatible with each other. So what's going on here? We are going online to the space-time diagram and play with it and see what happens. I will show you, but you can go there as well and do it with me. So here it is, the space-time diagram. And let's break it down one by one. In the red, I have two sliders prepared, and you can use them yourselves, but I have a perspective slider and a speed slider. The speed is now set at 80% of the speed of light for the rocket from the perspective of the shed. So the shed is not moving in this perspective. We are in the farmer's perspective, so the shed is always at the same place. It's just moving through time. And this is the space-time diagram. Location is on the horizontal, time is on the vertical. And here we see in blue the rocket. And the rocket is not 25 meters long anymore from the farmer's perspective. It's 15 meters long because it's traveling so fast. And you can just take your cursor and click grab and drag the time, and you will see that the 15 meter rocket now enters the shed, the front of the rocket. Now the back of the rocket is in the shed. Let me zoom in. So you see this is the left door of the shed and the right door of the shed, and the rocket itself is completely in the shed now. So you can take the picture and then the rocket will fly out. So this is what happens. And I can put in some other events. Let me put them on here. Lots of events, but I'm going to zoom in and out all the time. But what first happens here is that the front of the rocket enters the left door, door A. So let's see when that happens. So I have to move this a little bit. So here, boom, that's an event. The tip of the nose of the rocket enters the shed. Then it starts moving in, moving in, moving in, moving in, moving in, moving in. And then the next event is here, boom. This one, here. The back of the rocket also enters the shed. Then we progress time a little bit further. And here we will close the doors because, you know, the rocket is in the shed. At T is zero, we will take the picture. Well, in this case, we are videotaping, but you could take the picture and you would actually see the shed with closed doors, the rocket inside of it, although the rocket is much bigger than the shed. This is actually true. You can do this. Then the doors open again and the rocket leaves the shed. So I have put in like 13 events, and I'm not sure. If you zoom out, I think I put them all here. Yeah. So these are all these events. Event number one is the farmer with the camera stationary. The back of the rocket is always noted as E2. Event number three is the front. This is when the rocket front meets door A, which is the left door. Then the back meets the left door. Then the, the back meets the left door. Then both doors close at E6 and E7. The shed and the rocket are centered at E8. Event number 9 is taking the picture. Doors open again at E10 and E11. Then we have event number 12. The front of the rocket is now at the second door. And this is 11. Event number 13 is when the back of the rocket leaves the shed. You know, leaves the... Is that true? Ah, it says here A, but I think that should have been B. Yeah, this is B. This is an error. Just read B here. But okay, anyways, you get the picture. It flies in, flies out. And all these events are here in the diagram. And if you change perspective, you will see that all these events change in the space-time diagram. You know, this is the stretching and the time dilation, the length contraction, switching perspectives. My animation doesn't hold up for all possible situations. So if you want to switch perspective, then you need to hide some of this stuff. But let's stay in the farmer's perspective for now, because this is reality. This was animation number one on the top left. Now let's look at the videotape of the rocket in farmer's perspective. Ha! For those who have watched level 32, you can recognize here what's going on, right? I have to zoom out. But this is the blue one, is the actual rocket. But the purple one is the rockets as seen on the video. And it comes in at a much bigger speed because of the slope. And then it does all this crazy stuff when it's in the shed. You know, it does like this. And then it leaves the shed with a constant length again. So this is what we see on the video. Well, I'm not going to explain why this is, you know, because I did in great detail in the previous level. But here you can see those with these events. So, well, let's make it a little bit less clouded. Put those away. I'm going to use everything away. And now we are going to look at the rocket's perspective. Let me quickly change this to rocket perspective. This is the perspective from the rocket. The blue rocket, 25 meters long, minus 12 and a half, plus 12 and a half. And it's just moving through space, not going anywhere. And it sees the shed coming after him. First, the shed is meeting the back of the rocket. The front of the rocket. Now, the rocket is sticking out of both ends of the shed. And sometimes later, the shed has gone through and the rocket is still stationary, of course, here. And the shed is now leaving the rocket. So this is from the perspective of the rocket. This is the true events. This is what actually happens. And also here we have all these events when doors open and close. And now you see, for instance, that closing doors is not at the same timestamp anymore on the video. Door B closes here. And when does door A close? All the way here. Here is door A closes. If you were in this perspective of the farmer, that will be simultaneously. But from the perspective of the rocket, these events are not simultaneously at all. So here you can see what really happens. So this is the animation in the bottom row on the left, the actual reality from the rocket's perspective. I did not build in all the lines for the videotape of the rocket, but it's exactly the same logic as the one that we used when we did it in the farmer's perspective. If you really want to know what's going on here, you can click open all these things and see the all the magic behind all the equations. You can see what's going on here. I did not made it look the best it could, you know. I made it work. Let me put it that way. I made it work. So I made, of course, a gazillion mistakes with minuses and pluses. But, you know, in the end, I made it work. And if you take the time and you have the patience, you will be able to figure this out on your own as well. So there we go. You can just go online and play with this stuff. Let's go back to the slides. Here it is. Is this it? This is it. You have mastered the big rocket in the small shed using the space-time diagram. Here are my other levels. I always end my videos with this one. You can pause the video, see if there's anything you like. Level 1 all the way up to level 34. We are now at 33B. So in the next level, the C level, we will do the actual math and calculations. So you know exactly how big is the shed, in which perspective, when do doors open and close, etc. And the magic will be revealed from a mathematical point of view instead of from a story or a visualization in the space-time diagram. I want to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at the next level.